back, students, to the fourth session of Basic to Advanced Java series, where you and me are going to learn, code, and execute Java problems together. So, our problem of the day is factorial of a number. So, students, what exactly is a factorial of a number? First, let me tell you, it is denoted by, if a number is n, it is denoted by the number n and an exclamation mark. This is the factorial. The denotation of factorial is the number n and with a exclamation mark. So students, what exactly is factorial of a number? Let me tell you the theory. So theory goes as, it is the product of all the number lesser than the number n. If our number is n, the factorial of number n is the product of all the number lesser than the number n, and also the product of number n itself, which means if our number is 5 and we have to find the factorial of number 5, it will be 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is 120. If you want to recheck, students, 5 into 4 is 20, 20 into 3 60, 16 into 2 is 120, and 121 into 1 is 120. So students, now we are going to create a logic where we'll be finding the factorial of any number. Okay, students. So let's get started. Let us create a public class. As I have said this before, why we are creating a public class? Because each public class, every Java application should have a public class with a main method inside. Okay, let us name our public class as factorial. Now we have to create the entry point of our class, public static void main. So now, students, we have to initialize some of the variables. Let us take our number as 5, and we have to initialize our factorial variable as 1. Okay, students, now for our factorial to work, we have to create a for loop which will be starting from 1, which will go till number num that we have provided, because our number is 5, then the product will be the factorial will be the product of itself. Okay, students, and we want our I to be increment. Now students, the logic works as, we will multiply the number of factorial with each iterations, and we will update the number of we will update the factorial. Okay, and then we will simply print out the number of the factorial. But students, there is also a catch. Here we are inside a for loop. We don't want to print a factorial each number of times at each iterations. We only want the last factorial value. So what we'll do, we'll print this outside of for loop, which will be here. And let us run our code. Voila, 120. So let us take our number to be 7. I think the factorial of number 7 would be 5040, as I remember it. Yeah, 5040. Let us consider another number, 10, which the factorial I really don't know. 3628800, not a good number. So students, this is the very basic logic of our code, how to find the factorial of a number. So students, this is our desired output. Keep learning, keep practicing. Signing off.